Hi, welcome to Dream Big Stories. Today's story is The Very Cranky Bear by Nick Bland. 你好，欢迎来到远大理想讲故事时间。今天的故事叫一只暴躁的熊。In the jingle jangle jungle, on a cold and rainy day, four little friends found a perfect place to play. Moose had marvelous antlers, and a lion a golden mane. Zebra had fantastic stripes, and sheep, well, sheep was plain. 在一个阴雨天的丛林里，四个小伙伴发现了一个完美的地方可以玩耍。驼鹿有一双绝妙的鹿角，狮子呢有金色的鬃毛，斑马有很棒的条纹，而绵羊呢，它很普通，什么也不特别。None of them had noticed that someone else was there. Sleeping in that cave was a very cranky. 他们谁也没有注意到，山洞里还睡着一只脾气非常暴躁的。Bear, roar, went the cranky bear. Roar, roar, roar. 熊，哇！暴躁的熊咆哮如雷，哇哦！ He gnashed his teeth and stomped his feet and chased them out the door. 他咬牙切齿地跺脚，然后把他们四人赶出山洞。So.In the jingle jangle jungle, on a cold and a rainy day, four little friends had nowhere warm to play.
所以在这个又冷又阴的丛林里，四个小伙伴没处可玩。
Wait a minute, said Zebra, as she scratched her furry chin. Maybe if we chilled him up, he'd let us come back in.If I did not have stripes, said Zebra, I'd be cranky too. We should give that bear some stripes. That's what we should do.
等一会儿，斑马说着抓抓下巴。如果我们能使它高兴，它也许会让我们回去玩。斑马说，如果我身上没有条纹，我也会变得很古怪。我们应该给那只熊一些条纹。
Stripes are silly, Moose complained, especially on a bear. My antlers always cheer me up. Let's give that bear a pair.
条纹真傻，驼鹿抱怨道，特别是画在一只熊上。我的鹿角总能让我打起精神，让我们也给它一对吧。
No, 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 said Lion.Antlers are a bore. A golden mane like mine, he said, would cheer him up for sure.
Oh, 不不不不不，狮子说，鹿角真无聊，像我一样的鬃毛，他说，才能真正使他高兴起来。
So, Zebra fetched a tin of mud, and the lion some grass of gold. Moose got two big branches, and sheep.Well, sheep got cold.
然后，斑马拿过来一大桶泥巴，狮子拿了一些金色的稻草，驼鹿找到两个大大的树枝，绵羊呢？哦，绵羊感冒了。
Sheep was getting worried. They've been eaten up for sure.
绵羊开始担心，它们会被吃掉的。
And then,From in the cave, there came a very cranky.
然后从洞里出来了一只脾气暴躁的
Roar! Zebra, Lion, and Moose ran out, and the bear was right behind them. They hid behind the bushes, while they hoped he couldn't find them.
哇，熊咆哮着。斑马、狮子和驼鹿逃跑出来，熊紧紧跟着他们，
他们藏在树林里，希望熊不要找到他们。
Why is he still cranky? He's got antlers, stripes, and mane. Before we gave him those, Lion said, he looked so very plain.
为什么他还是那么暴躁？现在他有了鹿角、条纹和鬃毛，在我们给他之前，他看上去是那么普通。
As Bear stormed back inside the cave, he turned and roared at the sheep. All I really want, he said, is a quiet place to sleep.
当熊暴躁如雷地返回洞中时，他转过来向绵羊咆哮，真正我想要的，他说，是一个安静的地方，可以睡觉。
So, she fetched a pair of clippers, and she clipped off half her wool. She stuffed it in a cotton bag until the bag was full.
所以，绵羊去拿了一大把剪刀，他剪下身上的一半的羊毛，他把羊毛塞进棉袋里，直到袋子装得满满的。
She tiptoed back inside the cave. Excuse me, Bear, she said. Would you like a pillow for underneath your head?
她踮起脚尖回到洞里。对不起，熊，她说，你想不想要一个枕头放在你的头下方？
Well, thank you very much, said Bear, and soon he fell asleep.Maybe he was dreaming of a plain but thoughtful sheep.
Oh, 非常感谢你，熊说着很快入睡了。也许他是梦到了一只没有什么特别，但是非常善解人意的绵羊。 This is the end of the story.好的，下面让我们来回顾一下语言点。第一个 cranky 古怪的、暴躁的
the very cranky bear
一只暴躁的熊。第二个 plain 朴素的、简单的
sheep was plain
绵羊很朴素。第三个 clippers 大剪刀
she fetched a pair of clippers
她取来一把大剪刀。第四个
thoughtful
体贴的
a plain but thoughtful sheep
一只朴素但很体贴的绵羊。
Okay, this is the end of the language part. Thank you for joining me today. I will see you next time. Bye.
好了，今天的故事就到这儿，我们下次见吧。再见。